This conference will now be recorded.
Yeah, hope it's audible to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So in the last class, we were discussing about what hierarchical report. Hierarchical report means displaying the data in the form of what header and what item data. Okay, displaying the data in the form of header and what item data. So this was the requirement. Okay, we need to get the sales order header data and then the sales order item data, and I need to display the report in this format. We need to display the header record, below that corresponding item record, again header record, below that corresponding item record. So in the last example, in the 46th example, what you have done is this, anyhow, we know we have generated a selection screen for reading the range of what sales documents. Okay, suppose here, let me give it as, here I gave the range as 10 to 100. So initially we are getting the header data into the internal table T_sales_header. If the header data is available, we are getting the item data from what VBAP table, and each time we are appending it to the internal table, comparing with the sales order available in the header internal table. Then we are displaying the data. First, we are looping the header internal table, we are displaying it, and under that we are looping the item internal table, comparing with the header record, so that we are getting the output something like this. Okay, this is the result we got. We got the header record and below that corresponding item record. But there was a performance issue in this. What was the performance issue? When we are getting the item data, we are looping the header internal table, so that each record will come to work area. Then inside the loop end loop, we are writing the select statement. It is recommended not to write the select statement inside the loop, because the number of times the select statement execution depends upon the number of times the loop is iterated. If the loop is iterated for 100 times, 100 different select statements will be executed, which will increase the network traffic, which will increase the load on database server, thereby decreases the performance of the application. We are getting the required result, but there is a performance issue. So what is the next thing you have to do? The change you have to do is, we need to avoid the select statement inside what loop. We need to avoid the select inside the loop. So let us see what are the changes we need to do. So I'll copy this 46th example to 47. Done. Okay, so same thing. First, we are getting the header data from VBAK table into this internal table. Then if the header data is available, if the header internal table is not blank, we are trying to get the item data. So what is the agenda? We need to avoid the select inside what loop. So I'll just comment it. This is not recommended. Not recommended. Okay, not recommended. So what I'll do here, I'll say, so if you observe here, if the header internal table is not blank, if the header internal table is not blank, then we have to get the item data. So here I'll say select VBLN item number, material number, net value from VBAP into item internal table. What is the item internal table? T_sales_items. Okay, sales items. I have to get the item data for all the sales orders available in the header internal table. So I need to compare with all the records of the header internal table. So you have to say for all entries in, what is the header internal table? T_sales_header. What is the common field between this database table and this internal table VBLN? So we need to compare the logically related field. So where weblen is equal to T_sales_header - what VBLN, hyphen VBLN, that's all. Okay, so no errors. When I execute, we are getting the same result. We are getting the same result, but we have avoided the select inside what loop. So let me debug this. I'll put the breakpoint. Yeah, this is my select option range 10 to 100. Let me switch to desktop 3. So if you see these select options, what is that? SO underscore weblen is my select option. So if I double click on this, so what is the structure of the select option? Sign option low I, lower limit is 10, upper limit is what? 100. I can also check it here in the tables. What is the internal table? SO underscore weblen. Select option is an internal table in the runtime. So it has got one range, one entry, inclusive between lower limit and what? Upper limit. Then we are having two internal tables. One is header internal table. As of now, it is blank. Another is item internal table. It is also what? Blank. First, we are trying to get the header data. So let me say F5. Control is jumping to the subroutine definition. We are getting the data from what? Header database table. What is this? VBAK into the header internal table, comparing with the select option range. So when I say F5, how many sales orders I got? 91 sales orders. I got 91 sales orders into this particular internal table. So comparing with each sales order, I need to get the item data. Where the item data is available in the VBAP table. So we need to fetch the data from VBAP table, comparing with each record of this particular internal table. You have to compare with each record of the internal table. In that comparison, with what field you have to compare? Weblen. So there should be one logically related field between the target database table and the source internal table. Now this is the source internal table. Already the data is there in this. Comparing with this data, I need to fetch the data from the target database table. So what I am doing here, yeah, if the source internal table is not initial, if it is not blank, yes, it is not blank, it has got 91 records. I am calling another subroutine get sales items. Control goes there. So what is that logic we are written here? Select the data from target database table VBAP into this item internal table, which is having zero records at this stage. For all records in what? Source internal table. For all entries in what? Source internal table. What is the common field between this target database table and this source internal table? VBLN. That VBLN you have to compare by using what? Where class. Where VBLN is equal to T underscore sales header hyphen VBLN. So let's see how many item data I'll get for this 91 sales orders when I say F5. Yes, I got 101 item records for this 91 sales orders. Now I'm displaying that. So I'm calling the subroutine. Okay, first I'm sorting it by weblen. Then I'm sorting the item data based on the combination of weblen and item number. Then we are looping the header internal table. Header data will be displayed. For this header data, I need to display the corresponding item data. So I am looping the item internal table into work area, comparing with the header record. Each record will come to what? Work area. I am comparing with that. The common field between these two internal tables is weblen. That's what I am comparing here. So when I say F8, I got the required result. So how different is this is from earlier example is, in the earlier example, we have written the select inside the loop. Here, only one select statement will be executed. Here, the number of select statements depends upon the number of times the loop is iterated. So we are improving the performance. Okay. And in order to display the data in the header and item format, we are looping the header internal table. We are looping the header internal table. Below that, I am displaying the item data. So we are writing loop and what? End loop. We are writing loop and what? End loop. Okay, I can avoid this also. Okay, this is nothing but a nested loop. Loop within the loop. Loop within the loop. So what I'll do, I just want to avoid the nested loop, because again, it may degrade the performance. So let me check how to do it. So agenda is, I need to display the same report, but instead of using two loops here, I want to avoid the nested loop. So let me comment everything. Okay, I'm commenting this part. Okay, so see the technique here. Already I sorted the data. I sorted both the internal tables. Now here I'll say loop at t underscore sales items into work area. What is the work area? W underscore sales items end loop. So directly I'm looping what? Item internal table. Directly I'm looping the item internal table. Okay, directly I'm looping the item internal table. Then here what I'll do, so each record will come to what? This work area. Now see the technique here. What is the agenda here? First you need to display the header record. Below that only I should display the item record. So I'll say inside this loop end loop, I will use one event called as on change of. On change of W underscore sales items hyphen what weblen. On change of W underscore sales items weblen. I'll say end on. See what I'll do. Format. Not here. Yeah. Here I'll say clear W underscore sales header. I need to get the header data. So here I'll say read table. What is the internal table? T underscore sales header into W underscore sales header where, not where, read table, so and so with key. With the key weblen is equal to W underscore sales items hyphen what weblen, hyphen weblen. If size of bars is equal to 0, let me give some color format, format color 3. I'll display that, right? I'll display the header record, W underscore sales header, hyphen what, weblen. I'll debug and explain, then it will be simple. ERDAT, header data, time, and the name of the person who has created. And if done, end on is over. And below that, I'll display the item data, format color 7, right? I'll start printing it from fifth space, W underscore sales items hyphen weblen. NETWR, and here I'll say format color off. Okay, so let me just execute and check whether I'm getting the result or not, then I'll debug. Yeah, I got 10, 11, 14. Twelve and 13 doesn't have item data. Okay. One second. Yeah, 12 and 13 doesn't have item data. Okay, done. Okay, so right. So see here when I execute this, I got the header record. I got the below that item data, header record, item data, done, 15, 16, done. Working fine. Okay, so let me debug this entire program, try to focus. Okay, this is my select option range. So we know that select option is an internal table in the runtime. What is the structure of the select option? Sign, option, low, and what? I. So if I go to desktop 3 view, yeah, what is the select option I give? SO underscore what? Weblen. Right, so if I double click on this, it's an internal table. In the runtime, it is an internal table. If I click on this, yes, you can see in the tables tab, it is showing that entry. The default value for select option is what? What happened? One second. Okay, so here it is showing. So you can see the tables tab, it is showing that. What is this? It has got only one entry, that is inclusive between 10 and what? 100. Done. Okay, and I'll come back to this. We have two internal tables, T underscore sales header, T underscore sales headers, both are empty. So first I'm calling this subroutine. Based on my select option range, I am getting the header data into the header internal table. So when I say F5, I got 91 records from the VBAK table. Done. If the header data is available, if this internal table is not initial, not empty, not blank, I am calling the subroutine get sales items. So what is the agenda here? I have to get the item data for all these particular sales orders which are available in this internal table. How many sales orders are there? 91 sales orders are there. So earlier what we have done, we have looped this internal table. Inside that loop and loop, we have written the select statement. We understood that is the performance issue. So what I am doing is, now without using select inside loop, I am going to use for all entries as part of what select statement. So what I am doing, I am getting the data from target database table VBAP into this target internal table, comparing with what? All the records of what? Source internal table. What is the source internal table here? T underscore what? Sales header is the source internal table. For all entries means for all records of this internal. How many records are there? 91 records are there. In each record, okay, in each record you can see I need to compare with what? Weblen. I need to compare with the Weblen part. So what I'll do for that is here. Yeah, here for all entries in terms of what is the common field between this database table and this internal table? Weblen. Okay, so I need to use the where class. Whenever we use the for all entries, it is mandated to use what? Where class. Suppose here when I'm getting the item data, let me not use any where class. I'm not using the where class. Simply I'll say for all entries and so on. So when I do syntax check, yeah, I got an error here. Dot is invalid here due to grammar, contains an invalid character or it is a so and so. Okay, so if you execute the same thing, if you execute the same in the older versions, it is clearly give a message saying that where class is missing. So in this ESP7, they have modified this particular error message. They're saying dot is invalid here. So dot is unexpected here. So the thumb rule is whenever we use for all entries in the select query, you have to use the where class. What you are doing in the where class, you have to compare with the logically related field between the target database table and the source internal table. In this, the common field is what? Weblen. Here the field name is what? Same. The field name need not be same, but the purpose of the field should be what? Same. In this case, the field name is what? Same. Done. So I'll get the item data. Now I need to display the header record below that corresponding item record. So see here, earlier what we have done, we have written the nested loop. We have looped the header internal table, we displayed the header data. Then inside that loop only, we are writing one nested loop. Okay, we are looping the item internal table comparing with the header record. So again, this is slightly performance issue. Writing the nested loop is again a performance issue. So what I'll do here, I'm using on change of event. So just see the technique here. Loop at T underscore sales items and so on. So done, I've activated this. Let me put the breakpoint here. I'm directly putting the breakpoint here. Done. Yeah, see this? We have two internal tables. One is T underscore sales items. It has got how many entries? Oh, let's say F8. Yeah, done. This T underscore sales items has got how many entries? 101 entries. Okay. So I'm looping that. So when I loop, what happens? Each record will come toward work area. So I'll say F5, done. I'll get the record into the work area. So what is the work area here? W underscore sales items, hyphen what? Weblen. What is the Weblen I got here? 10. So if you see this internal table, okay, this is my internal table. Acha, this sales order has got how many items? Only one item. Fine, leave it. So just see this. First, I need to display the header record. Below that, I need to display the item record. So what I'm doing here, loop at T underscore sales into work area. I got the record into the work area. Now I'm saying I'm using what event on change of event, on change of, try to understand, on change of W underscore sales items hyphen what? Weblen, on change of W underscore sales items hyphen Weblen. Okay, so is it a new Weblen here? Yes, on change of W underscore, it's on change of means whenever a new record is encountered, this event is triggered. Whenever there is a change in this particular field, this event will be triggered. Anyway, this is the first time, it is a new value only, there is a change in the Weblen. Earlier it was blank, now there is a change, I got 10. So it will enter the event, it will enter the event. Then what I am doing here, for this Weblen, I have to get the header data. Where is the header data available? In the header internal table. So read table T underscore sales header into work area, comparing with this particular Weblen. So I'm doing it, F5. Yes, my read is successful, size of bar is zero. I'll get the header data. I'll get the header data. I'll display it. Then it is displayed. So if you see, this is my header data, Weblen. Then W underscore sales header, hyphen what? ERDAT. W underscore sales header ERDAT, like this. I'm displaying all the fields. W underscore sales header hyphen ER what? ZET. Then W underscore sales header hyphen ER NAM. Yes, I displayed it. Done. I got the error data. So if you see the output, how to see the output here? This is my new debugger screen. I'll go to settings. Where is it? Yeah. In the miscellaneous menu, we have a display list. What is the record I got here? I got the header record, sales document number, creation date, creation time, and created by. Done. Okay. Now, then below that, I'm displaying the item data. Done, done, done. It has got displayed. Okay, it got displayed. So, here it has displayed one item data below that. Done. Now, again, it will go up. Loop at so and so. Okay, I'm looping it again. What is the second record I got here? What is the second Weblen? 11. So there is a change in the Weblen. Earlier it was 10, now it is 11. It's a new record. So again, this event is triggered. So what you have to do for this sales order, I have to get the header data. So again, I'm reading it. Yes, again, I got the header record. So this is my header record. I'm displaying it again. Okay, it got displayed. It got displayed. Our record is got displayed. Done. Next, below that, I'm displaying the item data. I think only one item is there. Done. Okay, it has displayed the item data. Done. Now, again, I'm looping. Again, I'm looping. Done. So, what is the new Weblen now? 14. Okay, this is 14. So, again, it is a change in the Weblen. So, again, this event is triggered. I'm reading the header record. I got the header record. I'll display it. Okay, header record is displayed. Oh, I see. I pressed F7. It has displayed everything. So here, what you have to understand about this on change of event is, on change of event will be triggered. On change of event will be triggered whenever there is a change in what? This value. Suppose, just try to understand this. Or else let me debug it once again. One second, please. I'll debug it once again. Try to focus. This is important event. So let me debug once again. Yeah, I'm looping it. So I'm not interested in the first Weblen. What is the first Weblen here? 10 has got only one record in here. I'm just displaying it. Done, done, done. I'm pressing F5. How to come out of the standard code? F7. Done. What is the next Weblen? 11. Again, this event is triggered. Done. I'm displaying it. Done. So see the result so far. see the results so far. What I got? Sales order 10 has got only one item, 11 also has got only one item done. Okay, now I'm looping it. Yeah, what is the web length of 14? So if you see this internal table, W underscore sales items, not W, T underscore, the internal table is T underscore. Yeah, if you see here, related to 14, how many records are there? Two records are there. So keep this in mind, related to 14, there are two records done. So this is the first time this 14 is occurring. So on change of event is triggered. It will enter that particular event. I am looping the header record. I'm looping the header record. I'm displaying that header record. Done, done. It has displayed. Yeah, it has displayed the header record and the item record. Done. So if you see the result here, I got the header record as well as the item record. But how many items are there? Two items. Okay. So when I loop here, again the same web length will come now. It has got two records. Again the same web length. Done. Again web length is what? 14 only. On change of, is there any change in this web length? In the earlier iteration also it was 14. Now in this iteration also it is again what? 14. So since there is no change in this web length, since there is no change in the web length, this event will not be triggered. On change of event is triggered only when a new value is what? Encountered. When a new value is encountered. Now since it's the same value, this event is not triggered again. Means for a web length 14, only once this event is triggered. So when I say F5, see where it goes. It will not enter the on event. Then it is not entering. It is coming out of that on event. Okay, so on change of event means what? Whenever there is a change in this particular field value, this event will be triggered. Event is triggered means control will enter that particular on. It will enter that, it will execute that particular statement. So 14 has got two records. Only for the first record, this event will be triggered. Similarly, 15 has got two records. Only for the first record, this event will be triggered. Okay, 15 also has got two records. Only once it is triggered. So what is the changes you have done in this program? We are avoiding the select inside what? Loop. And we are avoiding the nested loop. Okay, how we are avoiding the nested loop? By using the on change of event inside what? Loop and what? End loop. Any questions, please ask me. Any questions here, anyone? Yes, anyone, any questions? So as of now, I am using the on change of event inside what? Loop and what? End loop. I am using the on change of event inside what? Loop and end loop. Now let's see the other example for on change of event. Just try to understand. This is the requirement. One second. Okay, so try to understand. Yeah, my requirement is I want to get some data from my KN1 table. Okay, I want to get some 500 records from my KN1 table. So this is customer master data. Try to understand. This is my customer master data. So my requirement here is here I'll have what? Customer number. Not customer number, sorry. Here I want to show country. Country is what? IN. Below that, I need to display the customer data. This is customer number, and this is what? Customer name, and this is customer what? City. Again, country. Country is suppose Argentina. Again, this country might contain what? Many customers. I should display customer number, and again, what? Customer name, and again what? Customer city. So I want to display the customers country wise. Okay, I want to display the customers country wise. So let's see how to do it. Okay, so let's see this. Type of program is executable program, done. So here what I'll do is, yeah, just try to understand the requirement. Overall, how many fields I have to display? Country, customer number, customer name and customer city from which table? KNAVEN table. So since I'm dealing with multiple records, I want what? Internal table now. So let me declare the internal table. First, let me quickly do it, then I'll explain, then you'll understand this. Kunnar type KNAVEN-F and Kunnar. I'm declaring the required fields. Land one type, what? KNAVEN-Land one. Then I'll say name one type KNAVEN-Name one. And then what? ORT01 type KNAVEN-ORT01 city. Okay, then end of what? TY underscore customer. Now based on this, I'll declare an internal table and what? Work area data t underscore customer type table of ty underscore customer. Then I'll declare a work area w underscore customer type ty underscore what? Customer. Done. See the technique. I'll not use any selection screen kind of thing. Directly I'll get the data. Select what? Select customer number, land one, name one, ORT01 from KNAVEN into table. Understood? Whenever you are fetching multiple records, I have to say what? Into table. What is the internal value displayed? Into table. T underscore what? Customer. T underscore customer. I will say here up to 500 rows. Up to 500 rows. I'm just saying get me 500 records. Okay, then I'll say if size of bars is equal to what? Zero means if at least one record is retrieved, select is successfully executed. Now if select is successfully executed, size of bars is set to what? Zero. So I'll get the entire data into my internal table. Let me try to display it. How do you display the data from internal table? You have to loop and display. So loop at t underscore customer into work area. What is that? W underscore customer. Then I'll say end loop. Okay, else I'll just give the message. Else I'll say no data. Right? What? No data. No data. End for if you got end if. Done. So let me save it. Check for the syntax. Done. When I execute, yeah, I'm not displaying it. So inside my loop and end loop, I'll say right. What are the work? W underscore customer hyphen. Customer number, then hyphen what? Land one, hyphen what? Name one, and then what? City. So let me quickly explain. I declared this internal table with how many fields? Four fields. Why four fields? My output requirement is overall I have to display what? Four different fields from each table, KNAVEN table. So I'm fetching some 500 records from my database table into the internal table. If the select is successfully executed, I am looping the internal table and what? Displaying. So when I execute, see here. Okay, I got the data. Okay, I got the data. So you can see here, this is my customer number, country key, land one and what? Name one. So this is not in sorted order of countries. Here I am in Germany, up to this Germany, then Japan, Germany, US. It's not sorted. So what I'll do, let me sort it. Here I'll say sort. T underscore customer by what? Land one. I want to sort it country wise. So I'm saying by land one. Sort the internal table by land one. So when I execute, good. So I can see I got all the Australias at one place. Then we got CN. Then we got DE. Okay, like this. We got all the customers country wise. Good. We got all the customers country wise. FR, France, Great Britain, India. Like this. So overall, we got how many records? Five Japanese, something like this. But what is my requirement? here unnecessarily I'm repeating the country na. So I want to display the data. I want to display the data country wise. Means country should be displayed only what? Once. Country should be displayed only once. Okay, so let's see how to do it. So what I'll do here, I'll say, just try to understand. I'll say what? On change of, on change of what? W underscore customer hyphen what? Land one. Whenever there is a change in what? On change of W underscore customer hyphen land one. Let me try to display only the land one. I'll say format color 3. I'll say right. Customer country is W underscore customer hyphen land one. Done. Format color off. Then I'll say what? End on. Then I'll say end on. Here I'll not display the land one. I'll display other fields. Let me give some space. I'll give some 5 spaces. I'll give a different color for this. Format color 7. Here also I'll say format color off. Format color off. Understood. So let me check it now. Execute, no errors. When I execute, done. Good. So I got what? Customer country is what? Australia. Below that I got the corresponding customer data. Again CN. Below that corresponding data. Done. Germany like this. France, Great Britain, India, US, something like that. Overall we are having what? 500 records. Japan, US, all those things. Understood? So this is simple, another example. So what I'm trying to show here is on change of means what? Whenever there is a change in the land one, this event will be triggered. So if I quickly debug this, see this. My internal table contains how many records? 365 records. Okay, actually I'm getting 500 records, but I'm getting 365 records only. Probably my table doesn't have more than 365 records. If I go to KNN table, maximum having 365 records, that's why I got 365 records. Done. So see here, this interval has got 365 records. So if you see the content here, yeah, Australia is repeating now. So my requirement is what? Country key should be displayed only once, below that corresponding customers. So what I'm doing here, I'm looping the internal table, loop at t underscore customer. Yeah, it's a new customer which is coming to the work area now. What is the customer in Australia? This is the first time we have iterated the Australia. So there's a change in what? Land one. On change of W underscore customer hyphen land one. Yes, it's a new value for the land one. This event is triggered. What I am doing inside this event, I'm just displaying the country key. Yes, country key got displayed. So if you see here in the miscellaneous display list, I got the country key. I got the country key. Done. Then below that, I am displaying the corresponding customer data. Done, displayed. We are in the loop only. Again, we are looping. Again, the second record is also same country key. Na? So again, the land one is what? Australia only. Same value. So there is a no change. There is no change in this field value. Since there is no change, this event will not be triggered. It will not enter the on end on. FI, it is not entering the direct. It is going there. It will display the rest of the fields, customer number, name one, and what city. Done, it has displayed. Done, done, done. I'm saying FI. Again, I'm looping. Again, Australia event is not triggered. Done, it has displayed. Again, Australia, done, not displayed. Again, Australia, not displayed. Australia, again, not displayed. Done. Australia, again, not displayed. Done. Australia again not displayed. Done. Again Australia. Okay. Yeah, this time there is a change in the land one. It's a new land one, na? New value. Na? So since it's a new value, again this event is triggered. It will go inside, it will execute that, it will display the country key. It will again display the country key. And below that again corresponding customer data. So this is the purpose of what on chain of events. So what we learned today is how to avoid select inside the loop, how to avoid the select inside the loop by using what for all entries statement as part of what select query. What is the prerequisites for using for all entries? The source internal table should not be empty. The source internal table, the source internal table should not be blank. And apart from that, what is the other thing? There should be at least one logical related field between the target database table and what source internal table, and that field should be compared by using what where class. That is one thing. And what is the other thing we learned? How to avoid the nested loop, how to avoid loop within the loop by using an event called as what on change of event. Okay, on change of event. In both the examples, I used the on change of event inside what loop and what end loop. But I can use the on change of event in other looping statements also. I can use it in while, end while, do, end do, all those things. Okay, while, end while, do, end do, I can use inside select and select also. Okay, as of now, in both the examples, I use the on change of event inside what loop and what end loop. What is the purpose of on change of event? On change of event is triggered whenever a new value is encountered for that particular given field. Okay, if the new value is encountered, that event will be triggered, the control enters into that event and execute the statement inside that particular event. So we can use that on change of event to avoid the duplication of the data display on the output screen, to avoid the data duplication, the display of data duplication in the output screen. That's what I am doing here. Any questions, please ask me. Done. So tomorrow what we'll do is we'll discuss on change of event in other than loop and loop. As of now, we are using on change of event inside loop and loop. But just now I told we can use on change of event inside other looping statements like while, end while, do, end do, select, end select, all those things. So we'll see that one, and based on that, we'll discuss about other events called as control break events. Control break events. Any questions for today? I have shared the last class recording, 23rd August recording I have shared yesterday night. Just go through that. This also I'll share it by today afternoon.
Yes, sir. There is some problem. I don't know. When I go and open that, it's not opening. It's in, we are processing that.
When you opened it immediately, when you saw my email.
No. Today only.
Just check it once again. If you have any problem, again, I'll reshare it. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Just right click on that and say preview. You should be able to open. Otherwise also, if you have the issue, you drop me a mail. I'll reshare it. Others also, please check it. I've shared the yesterday's recording. Done. So I'll wind up then. We'll continue tomorrow.
Okay, sir.